We're through towards the end of the project now, and it's a good opportunity just to go through what you do as an archaeologist looking at layers. Now we can actually, through this nice section through the graveyard, just actually explain and put you through some of the different layers and how we're actually putting together the site. And it's actually quite a good section in terms of what we're finding. We've effectively got just over 2 meters, probably about 2.2 meters from the top of the modern day graveyard to where I'm actually standing. And we're cleaning up on top of the original dune surface, which is probably here certainly before the medieval period anyway, but it's what we can think of this part of Leith, all the way through Leith Links, and actually probably through most of, all the way through to Portobello, this large area of undulating shallow dune systems. And this is very nice natural sands. Now, the top point is really what we have is this dark soil, roughly over just over a meter probably in depth to about here. Now this soil has been brought in really to form the graveyard from 18th and certainly the 19th and 20th centuries. And what we have here is this large wall coming through here. Now this is the base of one of the Georgian crypts that you can still see upstanding in sections towards the south of the graveyard and also just to the north. Now most, there was a whole line of crypts survived into the early 20th century, probably mid 20th century before they were demolished. I don't know exactly. This is just one of the foundations, actually the original pavement line. Is this right, just about?
Yeah, just about there, above with the green string line.
Just where the green string line. Yeah. So you can see we've actually done quite a lot of work over the last 3 to 4 months. So that was behind the graveyard wall that we took down. Now this earlier sort of mortar and stony layer, but the main thing is coming down. This overlies this what is the main graveyard soil. Now you can see that hopefully this sort of change in colour really, and also a bit more sandy. This is a very loam material, but we've got the sand, light brown sand, down for probably half a metre. Now that's the graveyard soil that we associate with the main graveyard that we're digging up from around about, goes from the church from the late 15th century all the way through obviously until the 18th century, but largely from 1480 to 1650, 1700. And then below it we have this change, and you can just see from roughly this, potentially even, I don't know, a bit of coffin.
That's a coffin in the section there.
People can see this sort of dark thin line. I'm just chasing it here.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's basically there's very faint traces of a wooden coffin. Now underlying that is this very mixed, very sandy soil. That's probably the original ground surface from 1300 back to back 300 or 400 years, and it's where the earlier graves are now cut from, which we've got this example here. Do you want to just explain something to
it? So we have a burial here, and as you can see, it sort of looks where its vertebrae is here, like it's almost been cut in half. And that's because essentially it has been by another grave, another coffin that we had here, which looks like when they've implemented that, it has cut this burial. It is in quite poor preservation. The bones are quite decaying and things, but and no indication of what kind of burial it is, whether it was a coffin, shroud, or anything like that.
So the dates we're looking at, possibly more of a shroud burial.
Yeah.
You find it's a lot of the earlier graves from the 1300s are more likely to be in shroud than coffin.
Yeah.
Also the fact that probably in poor condition, because when we decay, the body conditions could be a bit more acidic, so it might be dragging the bones. Mm-hmm. So that's certainly the case we've seen across the piece.
And we've had quite a lot of shroud burials. You see it a lot of the time in the feet, and they look very like wrapped and tight, and you can tell that that's how they've been shrouded.
And we're just, I mean, if you want to come in slightly, and one of the things is about archaeology is about looking at differences in soil colours and textures. Now, if you can actually come closer, you can actually possibly see. If you point this out, we think it's an earlier grave cut.
You can see here, this circular where the soil changes from this kind of orangey browny color to a light sort of mid brown. Here, this will be another grave cut. So we'll probably in this one find some feet or something.
That's wonderful.
Basically run through of the depth of deposits we're getting. Now, this is probably an average. We are, as we're saying, the dune surface again, when we're taking what we call a section across the site, we're actually recording the layers of how it's built up, but we're actually getting the original surface of the ground surface, the dunes, and you can actually see it slowly undulating across the piece, and we'll have a very nice drawing through that.
And you can see tied up. You see how in some sections the sand is quite high up in the sections.
Mm-hmm.
We've got the very darker soil just in the fore distance. And that's obviously something possibly from a very large pit or ditch that we found in 2008 that's cut through the central area. But that's going, you know, at least another metre or so below what was the original ground surface.
And then it sort of rises up towards the far end. So it's really quite interesting to see that properly for the really first time, because when we came in 2008 the road had taken the top of it, but now we can actually record the true surface of the ground surface here.
That's great, thanks.